My dear students, welcome back to my English literature class. I am Anjana Jindal and today I am back here with our chapter number 10 of our Mulberry book. And the name of the chapter is The Railway Children. So children, in my previous videos, I had explained you the story as well as the word meanings, question answers and few exercises also we had discussed. So now few more exercises are left of this chapter, which we will discuss today in this video, part 4. Okay, then our chapter will be completed. Okay, children. So children, let's start the exercises. And our first exercise is word wall, antonyms. You know what are antonyms? Yes, antonyms are the words with opposite meanings, isn't it? Yes, so from the story, find opposite of the words given below. Here, few words are given and you have to find out the opposites of these words from the story only. Okay, yeah, the words which are opposite and which are being used in the story. Those words only we have to find out and write here. Okay, so the first word is silently. Children, what is the opposite? What is the antonym of silently, which is being used in the story? Yes, talking. The opposite of silently is talking. Next word is well. So the opposite of well is pale. Yes, mother was not well, no? She was looking pale. Yes. Now the next word is cheerful. So the opposite of cheerful, which was used in the story, is tired. Yes, the word is tired. This is the opposite of cheerful here. Now next word is gradually. So which word is the opposite of gradually, which is used in our story? Do you remember, children? Yes, scampering. Scampering is the word which is used in the story and which is the opposite of gradually. Now, the next word, carelessly. Carelessly is, the opposite of this is mouse quietly. Yes. And the last word is straightened. Straightened means stood straight. Okay, straightened means stood straight. So, the word opposite to this, which was used in the story, is sit. Yes, the word is sit, which is the opposite of straightened. So children, these are the antonyms you have to write down in your copy. Okay. So children, now next exercise is grammar time. And the topic is conjunctions of time. Children, what are conjunctions? Yes, correct. Conjunctions are linking words. Connectives, right? Yeah. Connecting words are called the linking words. And what are conjunctions of time? Yes, the conjunctions or joining words that tell us about the time of events or happenings are called conjunctions of time. The conjunctions, I repeat, the conjunctions or the joining words that tell us about the time of event or happening are called conjunctions of time. Okay, so here we have to join the pairs of sentences by using the conjunctions given in the brackets. Okay, see the A part. She returned from the market. She was tired. So we have to join this pair of sentences, no, by using the conjunction when. It is a conjunction of time. So how will we join? Yes, see. She was tired when she returned from the market. We have joined these two sentences now? Yes. This is the work of the conjunction, to join the sentences or words. Now see, next one. B part. Alistair hid. He saw his friends. Conjunction of time, which is given in the practice, as soon as. We have to use as soon as to join these two sentences. Let's see how we will join. Yes, Alistair hid as soon as he saw his friends. Yes, now C part. We waited at the station. Our grandfather arrived. And the word given in the bracket is until. So, let's see how to join. We waited at the station until our grandfather arrived. Next part, D. Shweta ate dinner. She watched a film. And the conjunction within the bracket is after. Join using after. Shweta ate dinner after she watched a film. Now, E part. You are waiting. Have a cup of tea. And the time and the conjunction of time which is given in the bracket is while. So we have to use this conjunction while to join these two sentences. So have a cup of tea while you are waiting. Now the next one is we begin our work. The bell rings. And the conjunction is given in the bracket as when. So we have to join these sentences using the conjunction of time when. Okay. We begin our work when the bell rings. Both the sentences have been joined. Isn't it? Yes. Now the last sentence means the last part is part G. I go out in the rain. I take an umbrella with me. I go out in the rain. I take an umbrella with me. And the conjunction of time which is given in the bracket is whenever. So we have to join these two sentences by using the conjunction whenever. I take an umbrella with me whenever I go out in the rain. I take an umbrella with me whenever I go out in the rain. So children, this is the way to join the sentences using conjunctions. Okay. And all these conjunctions which are given in these sentences were the conjunctions of time. Okay. So children, now question number two is complete these sentences with ideas of your own. So here incomplete sentences are given to you and you have to complete these sentences with your own ideas. Okay, let's see the first one. A part. As soon as I go home. Now it's incomplete, no? Let's complete it. As soon as I go home, I will complete my homework. Now the sentence is completed, isn't it? Yes. Now B part. While you finish your work, I will go out for a walk. Now C part. When you reach school, so let's complete it. When you reach school, tell your teacher about your illness. Now the sentence is completed. Now the D part. See here, first part is missing and second part is given that until you tidy the room. What to do? Until you tidy the room. That's completed. You will not be going out to play until you tidy the room. Sometimes this your mother also says like this, no? That you will not be going out to play. You will not go out to play until you tidy the room. First tidy your room and then only you go out. Isn't it? Sometimes it happens, no? Yes. Now see the E part. After my examination. Now let's complete. After my examinations get over, I want to go to watch a movie. Usually children, when your exams get over, no, you also feel like to enjoy, to go somewhere to watch a movie or to have a party time or some other way to enjoy, no? Yes. Now F part, dash, blank is there, before the train arrived. So let's complete this. I reached the station before the train arrived. Understood, children? Children, our next exercise is punctuation. Our next topic is punctuation. So the exercise based on punctuation. See, here question number one. Use a full stop, question mark, or an exclamation mark correctly at the end of these sentences. So children, how to know that what we have to use at the end of these given sentences? See, let me tell you. Sentences can end with a full stop, a question mark, or an exclamation mark, as you all know very well. But how or when we use these correctly? See, sentences, listen carefully children, sentences that give information or make requests end with a full stop. Okay, this type of sentences end with a full stop. And the sentences that ask questions, they end with a question mark. Okay, and the sentences that express strong feelings and excitement, they end with an exclamation mark. Okay children, understood how and when we have to use a question mark, or when we have to use a full stop or an exclamation mark, right? So now let's start. See, a part, three sentences are given and we have to use a correct punctuation mark at the end. Is it 8 o'clock? What it seems? It seems like a question, no? Asking, someone is asking, is it 8 o'clock? Yes. So it is a question. So what we will put? Yes, a question mark. Okay. Next one. It is 8 o'clock. Means someone is telling something. Yeah, perfect. So a full stop. A set of sentence, no? Yeah. It is 8 o'clock. So we will put a full stop at the end. Now, look at the time, I am late. Oh, a strong feeling, no? Expressing a feeling, oh, I am late. So, an exclamation mark. Now see, we part again, three sentences are given. Let's see one by one. I am going to the market this afternoon. What it's expressing? It is giving an information, isn't it? Again, it is giving an information, so we will put a full stop at the end. Next one, how expensive things are. Oh, an exclamation. Next one, will you buy? It's a question. So, a question mark will come at the end. Now, part C. Again, three sentences. Let's see one by one. Has Pallavi gone to the library? It's a question. What will come at the end? Yes, a question mark. Question mark will come at the end. Pallavi has gone to the library to borrow a book. So, information. An information is given to us. Here is our information given to us. So, full stop will come at the end. Now, what a good story this is. Yeah, excitement. So, an exclamation mark will come at the end. Now part D, how hot it is. Again, a strong feeling, feeling too hot, so expressing that. What will come here? Yes, an exclamation mark will come here. Now, it is a hot day. You're telling us it is a hot day. So, a full stop will come at the end. Yes. Now, the last one, how hot is it? How hot is it? Asking how hot it is it? Questioning. It's questioning, no? So, a question mark will come at the end. So now, children, I hope you understood all the exercises very well. You understood the whole chapter well, right? Now, it is your home assignment. Here, one write well. Story writing part is given for your homework. And with this, your chapter completes over here. Okay, so see your homework. Look at the pictures given below. What do you think is in the box? What do you think happens next? Use your imagination and write a story based on these pictures. add illustrations to the story. So children, just use your imagination. Imagine a story using these pictures, okay? And write with your own. Try to write with your own, okay? Rest you will get the PDF where all the answers will be available, okay? And I'm sure that you will enjoy this homework and you will imagine and frame out the sentences and try to form the story. Now you will feel very good. Yeah, it will be fun for you. Just try it. Okay? Okay then children, I hope you understood the chapter. Now it's completed. Okay, bye-bye. Take care.